Hello, hello. Welcome to this class, which is the 10th session of the intensive course on biblical finance. It is a true pleasure to be here with all of you. Let's commence, so please hit the play button to get started. Share with me and type in the chat right now about your place of origin and your current residence location. Look, the topic we will be discussing today is what is the optimal investment choice for your profile? Today, we're talking about investments. Yes, that's right. I've received so many questions here in the comments and in the live streams that I'm going to delve into the answer to the question that many of you ask me on social media. What is the question? Doctor, where can I invest? Yes, because I am aware that God wants you to make investments, and I am aware that you want to have your finances under control, make additional money, and start investing in order to fulfill God's dreams in your life and achieve financial stability. And as you know, in today's class previously, you were able to learn about the areas where you should not invest your money. Yeah, I've been freaked out by the number of people who have confessed to me that they've already bought one of these bad investments due to a lack of financial education. But it's not a big deal. There's time for everything under the sun. Yes, it's in the Bible, in Ecclesiastes. The crucial thing is that at this moment, you are present here in pursuit of knowledge. How? I did it a couple of years ago. And I know that if you haven't seen the classes this week, let me tell you that they are the biblical foundations of what we are going to talk about here today. Okay? And all the classes are still accessible on the YouTube channel, but they will be removed this upcoming weekend. All classes, with no exceptions, will be outside of the area on Sunday. So you need to prioritize this because the intensive biblical finance has a start date and an end date. So you must have priority about this intense, unprecedented, and free course. Therefore, make the most of this new opportunity, this prayer answer that you made to God and currently have, and do not delay it for a later time because you have an incredible chance of losing all the valuable content that it holds. All right. And a lot of people have asked me where he sees the classes this week. Look, there's a link down here below this video so you can access all the classes. Okay. In this event, I present a full content on finances in light of the Bible for you to start experiencing a genuine financial transformation. So in the event that I were you, I would not miss any class because it will be a continuation. Okay. Is that clear? We are already on the 10th class. And each one will have a phrase from the class as if it were a piece of a puzzle. Yes. Where are the super committed ones, super committed ladies? Yes. Write it to me in the chat and rub it in. Super committed, super committed. So make the most of this chance and obtain each individual item without charge in order to assemble this puzzle in your financial life. All right? And today, my objective in this place is to respond to the question, what is the optimal investment for your profile? Look, initially, I want to construct you up with the testimony of my mentee, Marilyn. Look at Marilyn's case, who in just 60 days already has extra money and is making her fifth investment to make her dreams come true. And nothing motivates me more than seeing how my students redeem their dreams, right? Look at the case of Marilyn.
My name is Marilyn. I work in the education field and I met through fees. Until I met the rich Christian, I worked to pay off debts. I've worked since I was 15 and now I'm 56. I came to the realization that I had not saved anything. I had no additional income, no savings. I had absolutely nothing at all. This caused me much anguish. I spent countless sleepless days and realized I was in a highly vulnerable situation. That frightens me. So I observed in this course the opportunity for a change and a chance for transformation. In the first classes that I started putting into practice, I already saw changes in my finances. Expenses were cut, which before I thought it was impossible to live without them. This course has been demonstrating to me what was significant and what was not in our expenses, and I began implementing cost-cutting measures to reduce our expenditures. I also used to pay fees at banks. At the banks where I have accounts, I would pay fees upon fees, and I didn't know that I didn't need to pay. I resolved all of that, reduced those fees, ultimately obtained even more money, and the great thing is that every month, Since I discovered this method, I started allocating my money to the right places, directing each percentage to its appropriate place of allocation. This allowed me to dream again, dream of buying my car, dream of taking a trip, and dream of things I didn't dream of before, couldn't have before. I desired to, but I couldn't do it. And the fascinating thing about the course, which I really liked a lot, is that it doesn't just work by showing us the path to financial freedom. Work has a profound impact on every aspect of our life. Therefore, he helps us gain insight into our own selves. To see and make changes in our spiritual life, in our financial life, of course, in our self-esteem, in our relationships, and then in our health. And that was really good, because you can walk this path of financial freedom with more security, and I found that very important. And one aspiration I had was to make investments, but how could I make investments if there was no money remaining? And the icing on the cake of this course is investment, and I thought it was wonderful. I am on my way to my fifth investment, and I am really happy to be feeling accomplished. Today, I see that I have the means and that I am going to achieve my financial freedom because I am heading towards it. I am enrolled in the right course and I can truly relate to this amazing course. What's even more exciting is that my 15-year-old daughter is also benefiting from the guidance provided. She is on the same path of learning about investing, saving money, and understanding where her money goes each month, including her allowance. I am grateful for the impact this course is having on both of us. So, God's blessing, I just have to express my gratitude to God for this and Christian Rich, because I'm feeling a sense of fulfillment and I'm experiencing dreams again and I have faith again.
Observing individuals break free from financial slavery and start dreaming again is one of the things that truly struck me and made me want to dedicate myself to this job. And why did he achieve this transformation? Why did Marilyn achieve this transformation? And that answer has everything to do with the phrase we were talking about in the previous class. Yeah, who can remember? Please write me down here. Let's see. Is that really true? Yes, it is. What was the preceding class? There is no worthwhile investment without knowledge and understanding. That was the phrase from the previous class, correct? Look, there's no good investment without knowledge and understanding. And she made a commitment to acquiring additional knowledge about finances. If you desire to achieve a genuine and enduring financial transformation, it is futile to learn from mere suggestions. When someone inquires, for instance, do you have knowledge of what the current hottest investment is? No, that is not the factor that will determine your proficiency as a skilled investor, a devout Christian investor. No, and why not? Because as I showed you in the last class, the market is cyclical. It changes quickly, and you have to be prepared to identify what is good and what is not good. Look, panic, yes, it is a trap. Every time I witness someone who asserts to possess some money and inquires about the ideal investment options, look, this question unequivocally reveals the profound lack of financial knowledge possessed by the individual posing it. And this even attracts individuals with malicious intentions who will try to persuade you to invest in something that benefits them exclusively rather than benefiting you. Yeah, this is bad, really bad. And you know what happens? You end up making one of the bad investments we talked about in the previous class. How unfortunate. That's why I always say that I prefer to teach you how to fish instead of giving you the fish. Because if I give you the fish, you'll always depend on me or someone else to give you that super advice. And that is not what I desire. What I desire is for you to genuinely undergo a transformation. You are a truly wealthy Christian. Do you recall the principle of sowing? Yes. And I demonstrated to you that you can cultivate your own money tree with the seeds that God entrusts to your hands. It is with those seeds of knowledge that you have the ability to plant numerous money trees. Keep in mind that each of us possesses seeds, but it is only those who sow them that will reap genuine wealth. Desiring to reap without sowing is not in accordance with godly principles. Cease your foolishness and the belief that God will provide money through a small bird or a container of gold. No, God, yes, he is able to do that. And perhaps he might even do it in order to fulfill some purpose or objective. However, that will not be the usual situation. Because in reality, God desires for you to acquire the knowledge of how to become a responsible caretaker. That's what's in the word. I even have a student, Pastor Elias, who thought that God was going to send him money just through a golden jar. Yes, I used to have that perspective. However, when he made a commitment to being a responsible caretaker, the financial outcomes in his life and ministry also underwent a significant transformation. There is no harvest without sowing. I repeat it because it's important. It's a very important phrase. This isn't the phrase of the class, but it's a really important phrase for your learning today. There's no harvest without sowing. That is the reason why we have to invest. Yeah. Girl, listen, Jesus left us one of the most important teachings regarding the financial life of a Christian, and it reflects the law of multiplication that leads to exponential growth. All of the resources that they give to us are talents. Yeah, that's what we have. And this, look, it is in the word. Jesus teaches us in the parable of the talents about the importance of multiplying our talents or our coins, emphasizing the need to make the most of the abilities and resources we have been given. Look in your Bible at Matthew 25, verses 14 to 30. It's all about the importance of multiplying our talents or our coins. And while exercise caution and be careful not to handle your money like the wicked and lazy servant and employee did in order to steer clear of their unfortunate fate. Yes, it is truly terrible. Look, this is a key legislation that plays a vital role in ensuring financial prosperity and economic well-being. Pay attention to this. It's in the word. If God clearly commands us to multiply the talents he gives us, both in material and spiritual aspects, it's a divine ordinance. In order to multiply our money, a good financial education is essential. We can multiply through investments, which will assist us in becoming highly financially savvy. And did not the school, the church, teach you this? Were you not taught this in school, in church? And that is one of the things I teach my mentees in a much more profound manner. In addition to subjects such as getting out of debt, having controlled finances, and making money to spare. We work with investment strategies in a deeper way. Right? And where are we super committed? Observe, at this moment, I do not possess any job opportunities. However, if there is a high demand for it, I will create some vacancies. But let's now proceed with our crash course in biblical finance. Now, I am aware that you must be wondering, look, doctor, my case is extremely critical. I have an overwhelming amount of debts. I don't have financial peace, and I don't have my finances under control. What's your opinion? Is your thinking like that? Do you think your case is really critical? Yes or no? And look, this is precisely the situation with my student, Adonai, who had a plethora of debts, but under the guidance of the comprehensive program, Adonai acquired the knowledge of how to enhance his income, and now he has commenced investing, a task that appeared unattainable to him. He transformed and diligently adhered to the methodology, following each step.
When I started this course, I had a lot of debts, was in overdraft, had credit card debt. First of all, I joined for the financial metamorphosis part during Christian Week. I understood that God was working in this area of my life that needed attention. Through this Christian Rich course, I found a way to control my finances using biblical principles. It was a transformative experience. I am grateful for the opportunity to learn and apply these teachings to my life. Now, I have the tools to manage my finances and achieve financial stability. I acquired knowledge and I desired to express that during the period when I was burdened with debts, I lacked the understanding of financial management, and subsequently, I successfully negotiated a repayment plan for my overdraft, as well as addressing the matter concerning my credit card. I was able to manage my income through learning and successfully earn some additional money. How did I make extra income? I managed to sell some stuff that was just sitting around here in my house. In addition, I managed to access the app and receive real estate recommendations. I even obtained a valuation related to it yesterday. Finally, I succeeded in applying and investing my money in the brokerage. I made the investments to save for my safety reserves and other investments based on the course. I was able to make these investments due to the course. Overall, I am pleased with my progress and the opportunities that have come my way. I will continue to utilize the app and make informed financial decisions for my future. So the course for me was extremely valuable, really good. I recommend it to everyone. It was definitely worth it, and I would highly suggest taking it. And for sure, that was the transformation that happened in my life. I'm even able to advise other people about financial life in my church. I've already told other people to take the course. So it's been really good. I came from the extreme where I was in debt, now investing. So I wanted to give this testimony about my transformation in my life. It's been really good. I appreciate it. Our first thanks goes to God and also to the whole team for this course, for being a part of it, and for God's guidance in transforming lives in this financial area. God bless everyone.
Many are asking about my mentorship. I offer an individual mentorship program called I Control My Finances to help people with their finances. This is a program for those who want individual tracking to put into practice what they are already learning for free here in the Biblical Finance Intensive. But as I've already stated, I currently have no openings for this program at present. Is that clear to you? And I do not want to deviate from the objective of this course, now free, which is to initiate your financial transformation completely and at no cost. Pay attention here. However, yes, by the way, at the conclusion of the free course, if we have a group of individuals interested in progressing with this mentoring with my comprehensive program, I Control My Finances, obviously we can take into account the possibility of initiating a new class, correct? If there's no one interested, no big deal. We're not opening this new class and we're ready here. The crucial aspect is that I am here fulfilling my objective of transforming you, of transmitting you this message via this complimentary course. And I do not want you to get distracted and lose focus. Please enjoy it and commit to the course because it has been God's tool to change lives. And we are going to reach our Christian week. I have control over my finances. That starts next Thursday, okay? Let's stay focused and make the most of this opportunity given by God. So, where are the super dedicated ones? Yes, are you all present? That is incredible, yeah. Receive this gift from God, this answer to your prayer for your life, so that you can start experiencing the kind of transformation you have seen in the different testimonies I have shown you. It's really important for you. We're back to the question from our class today. Let's go. Where should I invest? Which investment is considered good? Is the answer yes or no? What investment should I make? I must confess that when I receive this particular type of question, I already know that the person asking doesn't have much financial education. Why is that, you may wonder? My wish is to respond right away. Invest first in financial education for yourself. But well, since we are here as a family, I will confess what is going through my mind, okay? When someone inquires about investment options, however, in reality, this is my typical response, you know, it varies. What determines the optimal investment for you is your financial strategy. Look, actually, I am not going to be able to demonstrate to you as much as I would like in this class. Like, for instance, demonstrate to you all the existing strategies, delve into them, because just this topic alone would require many hours of training. However, I want to leave you here an introduction so you can start learning how to fish. Shall we? Yes? Who wants this? Please write in the chat. I want to know. Well, we can essentially multiply money in two primary ways. Pay close attention to these methods. One, investments, immovable assets that generate income, papers, stocks, bonds, metals, gold, silver, and other investments in general. Two, businesses, yes, franchises, participation in companies or business in general. Today, we will not talk about business specifically, but rather we will talk about investments in the financial market. Yes, we are going to discuss entrepreneurship in our Biblical Finance Intensive as well, but in a different class, all right? I have developed an extraordinary class on Christian entrepreneurship. Who is interested? Yeah, next week, all right? We have a class exclusively dedicated to this subject. How awesome. Now, with regard to investments in the financial market, listen up. I will explain to you some vital principles to assist you in making the right choices and minimizing the risk of your investments, okay? Who desires security in your investments, huh? I will inform you about some special rules regarding this. Is that acceptable to you? Rule number one, never invest in something you don't know, correct? It is really important. I have a very important rule for myself, which is to invest in what you know and can explain. Are you aware of that incredible investment your friend informed you about? Are you aware, yes or no? For instance, purchasing those cryptocurrencies, investing in dollars using someone's fund. Avoid it prior to acquiring complete knowledge about that investment, okay? Investing necessitates a continuous financial education. Attempt to comprehend all the actual risks and the potential returns on your investments. And in a short while, I will demonstrate to you what the three-way dilemma of a skilled investor is. Yes, it is a truly rich content for our class today. Yeah, let us go. Rule number two is important. There's a lot of content in this class. Pay attention. Have a plan for every investment. Specify when to enter. Specify when to exit. And most importantly, define your goal with each investment. If you do not have a purpose for your money, if you do not know what that money you are investing is going to be used for, then there is a high probability that the money will decrease in value and you will end up making a poor investment. How terrible and unfortunate it would be to experience such a negative outcome. It's really, really bad. So I want to encourage you to be a person who invests with purpose, okay? Rule number three. Yes, there is no magic formula or shortcut to make quick money easily. Desire for fast money? It is greed. He is not a follower of Christianity. Individuals desire a quick way. But the shortcut is not the right way. There is a correct path. And many people are not on the right path. They're in traps. In the shortcut, the risks are significantly higher. Even more so if you are just starting out and do not have any savings. Okay? Look, the Bible condemns greed and emphasizes that those who love money inevitably fall into different kinds of traps. Take note of this, you know? When they present me with that investment opportunity promising a remarkably high yield, I don't even bother examining it because I am aware that it's a trap. And legitimate investments should be able to generate wealth. And nowadays, there are many financial pyramids disguised as investments. Really? And the realm of investments is replete with pitfalls to ensnare the avaricious individuals seeking a speedy yield. Pay attention to that. So be cautious and vigilant of investments with promises of extremely high and extremely quick profitability. Rule number four, establish and expand your asset base. All right? You have already acquired knowledge about assets in this event, and you understand that assets are investments that generate income periodically, ensuring a steady stream of earnings over time. Assets contribute to your income without requiring you to trade time for money, thereby putting money in your pocket. Look, a job is not an asset because it requires your time to generate income. Assets generate income without needing your time, you know what I mean? A property that generates monthly income is an example of an asset. An action that generates periodic dividends is considered an asset. A company that generates a positive cash flow is an asset. You get it? Yes or yes? Well, now you understand what an asset is. That is the reason why you should always strive to expand your asset base. This will lead you to rely less and less on trading your precious time for money. You know what I mean? And the more active you are, the less you will depend on exchanging your time for money, the more you will be able to dedicate yourself to your calling, you know? And now I'm going to tell you a basic secret for any investor. Who do you want? Yes, yes, do you like it? All right, that is truly awesome. Kindly hit me up in the chat. I want to connect. Yes, please. A large amount of content in today's class. Yes, it is the dilemma faced by investors. Be attentive, and once you get to know him, you will know which is the top investment for your profile. Please bear in mind that we are currently in stage one of this intensive biblical finance course, and it is now time to prepare for the second phase, which is referred to as the Christian week, I control my finances. So we are still warming up because the real practice occurs in the second stage. In the Christian week, I have control over my finances, which starts in the upcoming week, okay? And if you haven't signed up yet, go ahead and register for free using the link in the profile, okay? So continuing with the content here, look, what is the investor's trilemma? What is it? One, and behold my apologies. And with regards to that, I must now introduce to you, for that reason, three fundamental concepts in investment and finance, which are of utmost importance. Look, the primary thing is the risk. You have to be aware of what the risk entails, which is the level of security associated with that investment. An investment with high risk has more chances of loss. A low risk investment has few chances of loss. So you have to keep in mind that you always have to evaluate the risk of the investments we make. The second one is liquidity. But what is this? If you need the invested money quickly, it would be available for you, yes or no. A highly liquid investment provides you with the flexibility to access your invested funds at almost any time you need. An investment with low liquidity can take a considerable amount of time, ranging from a few days to several months, to provide you with payment. This delay in receiving funds is due to the limited availability of buyers or sellers in the market for such investments. Yes, when I savor. Yeah. So let's move forward. Now, the third concept regarding profitability. The investment is more profitable, resulting in a greater multiplication of your money. He is making a larger sum of money with her. Look, an investment with low profitability will multiply your money more slowly. Do you comprehend? Yeah? Look, yes, excellent. Now that you have an understanding of risk, liquidity, and profitability, have you considered what the ideal investment would be? Contemplate. What's the perfect investment? What does everyone desire when they decide to invest their money? Low risk to make the investment safer? Yeah? High liquidity to be able to withdraw quickly whenever you want? Yeah? High profitability to earn more money? Okay. Unfortunately, I've got nothing but bad news for you right now. Yes, it is bad. This investment does not exist. No. And if it did exist, let me tell you, the demand would be so high that its profitability would soon decrease significantly. Do you understand? When precisely would this hypothetical investment come into existence? Look, every time I offer a high liquidity and low risk investment, a lot of people get interested and I don't have to pay high interest rates to those who invest with me anymore. You get it? It's a rule of finance. So you understand that a profitable investment implies a higher risk. It is normal. The more profitable the investment, theoretically, the greater the risk it entails. Theoretically, right? And why can't I just recommend you a super profitable investment? Why? Because this investment certainly carries a higher level of risk. Additionally, you must initially allocate funds towards financial education to understand your risk profile and learn how to effectively manage and mitigate these risks. Does that make sense to you? Yes? Do you want to minimize these risks? Look, today I want to show you a way to reduce this risk so that you can maximize the profitability of your investments. Look, Christians should invest. Yeah. And here's the class phrase for you to create a stories post on your Instagram account. I'm going to talk about the phrase. Just one more minute. Soon I'll talk to you. The phrase of today's class has everything to do with the biblical teaching that is in Ecclesiastes 11:6. Dear team, kindly put the verse Ecclesiastes 11:6 in the chat at this moment. The verse reads as follows. Plant your seed in the morning and do not let your hands be idle even in the evening, for you never know which one, whether this or that, will succeed, or if both will yield equally favorable results. Please ensure prompt input. Thank you. This verse brings us the idea of diversification. Yes, diversification is super important for your financial life. You never know what is going to occur in the event of a coronavirus crisis, like a pandemic, for instance, and the uncertainty it brings. Once more, or something similar, it may be wiser to invest in dollars or gold. Yes, diversification is important. Now, in the absence of a crisis, theoretically, stock prices must increase so that stocks can provide a higher return on investment and attract more investors. And how do we not know what is going to happen? There is a way to balance risk, liquidity, and profitability exactly with this teaching. You must have diversification. Have you ever heard of the concept of not putting all your eggs in one basket? Please answer with a yes or no. When it comes to your investments, that is precisely the same. You have to construct an investment portfolio in order to succeed. What is the investment portfolio? It's about having your investment portfolio. You're going to allocate a portion to a specific investment, and another part of the spectrum you're going to allocate to another investment. In the example I gave about the crisis, For instance, when there's a crisis, the stock market goes down and the dollar goes up. But the market is cyclical. It is not advisable to put all of your eggs in a single basket. I could leave a portion of my fan in dollar-linked investments, another in stocks, and another part in gold or fixed income, for example. However, it is crucial to emphasize at this moment that I'm not suggesting or advocating for you to invest in this manner, all right? It will all depend on which of the trilemmas you want to prioritize in your life today, whether you've got your finances under control or not, whether you're in debt or not. All I want is for you to understand the concept of an investment portfolio, which is a collection of various investments, each with its own specific functions. And this is a learning experience for you today, okay? If it's possible for you, even with little money, and this is something you must change in your mind, it's possible to invest with a small amount of money. It doesn't have to be millions, no. An investment that can aim to give you more liquidity and security are treasury bonds, for example, which exist in several countries around the world. Yes, and it's possible to invest with a small amount of money. Yeah, I'm talking about this. I know what I'm talking about. In addition to these, there are other investments that aim to make your portfolio profitable, which are usually investments in variable income, such as stocks or even bitcoins, cryptocurrencies, but with wisdom and seriousness from institutions within the appropriate range for you. I teach mentees how to invest in countries like Mexico, Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, the Dominican Republic, Honduras, and the United States. There is always a good investment opportunity when you have a clear understanding of your profile and what it entails. By acting this way, the risk always gets diluted. So there is no one-size-fits-all best investment. The inquiry is in plural form. What is the most advantageous investment portfolio? I have an additional question to ask at this particular moment in time. However, Doc, I'm wondering how I can create a wallet. Once again, the answer to that question relies on your specific strategy. Yes, depending on your objective, there exists a different strategy. I teach this valuable information to my students, to my mentees. And why do I only delve into and teach this in detail there? Because that is the specific place where we set our goals together. With each case, with each person's finances, based on that objective, that goal, the student starts to grasp where they should prioritize their investment. Yes, they begin to understand. Yes, a clear goal. There is no perfect mailman, you know? Yeah, no. You must have a clear objective, a goal to strive for. I'm going to talk about financial roots. During Christian week, I take control of my finances and get to work. What begins on Thursday? It is crucial for you to commence setting a goal. Here, I have already instructed you numerous things that you were not even aware of. I'm opening your eyes to a whole new world with my students. Before getting to the investment part, we define the goals, the objective. Learn this as well. For the time being here, I desire you to already have a financial transformation. I make a bet that with the information I have given you today, your perspective on investments will change forever and ever. If the Bible is effective for me, it will be effective for you and your country. You simply need to apply the principle of multiplication. Therefore, you should pay attention to this. You got to start making investments. You won't believe it, but you'll find an investment that's super profitable with high returns and high liquidity combined. You bet. There is something over there. Only those who have a clear objective, a target with their funds, will indeed be able to construct a strong investment portfolio with security, with clarity. So you're currently considering that if you had this information earlier, you would commence investing. However, I am already too old for that. I am extremely elderly, but hey, is there enough time for everything under the sun? Time waits for no one after all. Is it in Ecclesiastes? I would like you to examine the case of my student Aldades, who, after surpassing the age of 65, made her very first investment and commenced acquiring two brand new sources of income. If it was possible for Aldades, it's possible for you. Check out Aldades's video.
I, Aldedios Gomez de Oliveira Camarini Rodriguez, took the Rich Christian course and I'm 65 years old, a federal civil servant, with time to retire. But I haven't retired yet because I was looking for something for an extra income. Honestly, I found it in the course. as a transformation, on August 25th, I made my first investment based on the technical module classes because they are excellent. On September 1st, I made 3 more investments, all in Xinvest, Tesoro Diretto, and Selic. Only the first one, which is smaller, I invested in fixed-rate treasury bonds, but I did it safely because I learned from the course. And another thing, I also started working with vegetable composting. I already have knowledge, I have raw materials, I have space, vegetable composting, and I'm also starting a workshop for embroidery, painting, and crochet. Guys, I learned embroidery in my teenage years, but for some extra cash, it's the bomb. I'm happy, I've learned, I feel transformed, I feel like a new woman, because I'm already a new creature. Congratulations, I'll take the course.
And if you do not have financial education to invest, or perhaps you do not know how to invest in practice, the best advice I can give you today is make sure to invest in your financial education, okay? Remember that this is the finest seed you can sow to acquire more money and possess this crucial instrument to fulfill God's dreams in your life at this present moment. Look, today I have provided you with some excellent investment choices here. If you are interested in finance, yes, because I am discussing the principles of good investment. The optimal investment you can make, I have no doubt, is in your education in order to have a greater amount of money. In order for you to enhance your skills as a money tree farmer, as we have discussed in the concluding classes of this intensive biblical finance course, which has a specified start date and end date, if it clearly instructs us to multiply the talents that God has entrusted to us in both the material and spiritual dimensions of our lives. To be obedient to God in your finances, start making investments. And to multiply money, a good financial education is essential, right? Yes or yes? So if you've altered your mindset with all the information I've provided you with at this moment, create a stories using the phrase from today's class on Instagram in case you possess an Instagram account, and I will proceed to discuss it at this time. Look, I'm positive you'll share your extensive knowledge with the individuals you know, okay? Please don't forget to give the video of our class today a thumbs up and share it with others. Your support is greatly appreciated. Look, the phrase for today's class is answer the question that is the focus of our class today. Look, investing in knowledge always yields the best interest. This is the phrase we will be emphasizing and discussing during today's class. I'm going to do it again. Investing in knowledge always yields the best interest. You know what I'm saying? Look, many people inquire about the amount they should set aside for investment, and you do not require a large sum to invest. And I'll show you this exactly in practice. During Christian week, I got my finances under control, which is the second stage of this intensive biblical finance course. It is a closed event, and it is also free of charge, exclusively for registered individuals. If you haven't signed up yet, click on the link below this video and secure your spot, which is completely free. And you can also extend invitations to a greater number of individuals using your invitation link. In class, we'll change your mindset, but at the event, we'll get down to business. Investing in knowledge always pays off. Tomorrow, no class. Catch up on missed classes this week, okay? Enhancing understanding benefits in the long run. Make the most of this time to bridge learning gaps. Is that all right? And tomorrow we are going to have the screening of a special documentary entitled The Power of the Bible in Financial Life. Pay attention to the WhatsApp group so you know the schedule, okay? And in the next class, which will be on Monday, we'll talk about how to start a business and increase your income, right? Where are all the super committed people, right? Contact me. I will return on Monday. Affirmative, in person. Additionally, in the upcoming week, we will discuss subjects such as financial matters for couples. Christian entrepreneurship, how to start a business, increase your income. You will learn that financial independence is not independence from God. Let us discuss the concept of financial independence as well. Have you ever considered living off rental income so you can fulfill your calling? Let's discuss that in our class session. And what do I recommend you do this weekend? 1, you'll be able to see the previous classes that you haven't watched because I can only guarantee that they'll be available in the area until tomorrow. And I repeat, pay attention tomorrow to watch the special documentary that I will publish and that reveals the transformative power of the Bible in your finances. And if you believe you have comprehended that power and have not witnessed any of the classes yet, you need to view this entire documentary. I have doubts that you will not be impacted by the sound of the Holy Spirit in the documentary film. It's delicious. I think your financial transformation will begin when you watch this documentary and understand the power of what I'm talking about regarding the Bible. And I believe that if the Bible works for me, it works for you and your country. The content of the documentary and this intensive course about biblical finances works for you too. Team, please additionally release the list of individuals who attended. In the meantime, I am also publishing a video so that you all have the opportunity to check it out, all right? Prior to my departure, I would like to inform you that the designated keyword for today is investment. Kindly utilize the word investment to obtain your complimentary participation certificate. So may God bless you and see you on Monday. Big kiss and take care, my friend. Have a wonderful day filled with joy and happiness.
Two huge doubts in the banks that wouldn't let me sleep.
I couldn't find a way out of it. I spent my time in depression and crying.
I was really drowning in debt.
I was a person who owed almost $200,000.
I had a ton of debts for like 20 years. I was feeling down in the dumps.
I started to let go, to leave behind the fears, to leave behind the doubts.
I managed to free myself from everything, from that heavy and painful burden.
I felt calm and confident speaking to the Department of Criteria and presenting them with my payment proposal.
I've already paid off all the debts, and I almost have this house completely bought.
I have enough money now, because previously I didn't have enough.
I had 6 investments.
Imagine getting rid of a $200,000 debt and on top of that, having something to invest now. It's awesome. Thanks a lot.
It's a total blessing. And I mean like a really big one, like huge.
I'm happy because I'm free.
Because after the rich Christian, I start to see life in a different way. My financial problems were fading away. A mortgage on my house, which I would take another 8 years to pay off. I tell you that today I own a paid-off house. There are several other debts that were troubling me and having the ability to do something that had not occurred in years in my life. Having extra money of mine, my money never used to be extra. So managing to have some extra to invest as advised by the rich Christian in the portfolio we are following. Following the completion of the course, I successfully managed to have some money left over from my salary, which was an achievement I hadn't been able to accomplish for a number of years. I managed to pay off the debts, a debt of $23,958, if I'm not mistaken at the time. In a span of 60 days, I managed to completely pay off this debt. This, to me, was an invaluable accomplishment that I can't put a price on. In addition to that debt, later on, I also paid off another debt. So for me, this was crucial. So at this point in time, now that I have a certain amount of money left over from my salary, I started making an investment as well. I began investing some money and I did not have a car. I used to walk. I have a car now. It is not a fancy one, but I have a car in my garage now. This, in my opinion, is absolutely priceless. Wow, what an overwhelming feeling. I am filled with immense happiness and gratitude. I state that the wealthy Christian was positioned in my existence at a critical juncture. It was of utmost importance. So the rich Christian was truly remarkable. Compelled me to completely empty myself and wholeheartedly believe that those incredible people were there to provide unwavering support, invaluable mentorship, and invaluable guidance on how to truly eliminate debts, achieve a well-balanced financial life, make wise investments, generate additional income, unearth hidden talents, and gain clarity on my desired path in life.
I've already organized myself. I no longer have to borrow from loan sharks. I no longer have the private shops and businesses I had before because it was getting difficult. Everything is under control. My financial life is completely under control. I don't have that worry. One of the things I constantly had was power cuts. I couldn't handle it. Today I don't have. Sometimes I see a cutting car passing by and I breathe like this, then I don't have. I'm calm. Everything is up to date. The year 2020 was the first year that I ended with 1,500 riyals. I can say, thanks to the rich Christian, I'm at peace. I can have a much calmer financial life. Financially, I'm not a slave to finances.
The debts already existed, car financing, still paying for it. So there were quite a few things there, open debts, paying for land in installments, right? So that bar where we stayed, wow. And now what are we going to do, right? And that's when I started studying. I started the course slowly and began to see the transformations, many transformations. Reduction in bills. Surprisingly, I learned to do extra activities that we didn't even pay attention to before because we were in our comfort zone. So I acquired new skills and knowledge. I established an online store through the course where they educate us on the importance of continuous self-improvement, undergoing a shift in mindset, thoughts, and attitudes, and constantly striving to better ourselves. And that helped a lot. So with each step I took within the course, I saw the changes. And in the end, it was success, total success, both material and spiritual. It was wonderful.
I had some loans which were insured. And there we learned how to reduce these loans, how to pay off these loans. And we kept practicing this, exercising control. For us, it wasn't enough to do things halfway. It only served us to do it right, to do it completely. Today, I am able to sleep in peace. The complete transformation in our lives has been absolutely incredible and utterly profound. I initiated the story by discussing the debts I had, and presently, we are actively engaged in the process of making investments, my dear friend and partner in this venture. We are investors. At this moment, we were able to contribute and provide assistance to individuals in need, which is also a very impressive principle that makes a difference in people's lives. Today, I feel at peace. Today, I sleep peacefully. We still face our life's challenges. It doesn't stop. But today, I can plan, organize myself to achieve, reaching new things every day.